हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून सर. आई एम प्रोफेसर मुत्तन.
महादेवन
सर गुड आफ्टरनून, निगम सर गुड आफ्टरनून, मुत्तन
गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड
सर
आफ्टरनून टू
गुड.
ऑल.
சப்ளைல கனெக்ட் பண்ணிடு. சப்ளைல கனெக்ட் பண்ணி சும்மா இங்க வச்சிருக்கேன். சப்போஸ் அது சரியா வரலன்னா யூஸ் பண்றேன். இதில் காப்பி பண்ணிவிடு, சரி பரவாயில்ல. ஆமாம், அதான் ஈஸியாக இருக்கும். இது சொல்ல சரி, சரி பரவாயில்ல பரவாயில்ல பரவாயில்ல, விட்டு காப்பி பண்ணி போட்டு விட்டு.
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சார். Dr. Atul, have you joined?
Hello, madam, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay, okay. வருதா? அது பிரசன்டேஷன்ல போட்டு ஃபுல்லாவே ஸ்கிரீன்ல வர மாதிரி பண்ணிக்கலாம் இல்லையா? அப்படியே கிளிக் பண்ணுமா?
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சந்தீப் மாத்தூர் சார். சந்தீப் மாத்தூர் சார், குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சார்.
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன்.
எஸ் குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சார். யா சார், டைரக்டர் சார் கே லியே வெயிட் கர்தே ஹே, பஸ் ஜாயின் ஹி கர்தே ஹோகே.
டெஃபினெட்லி டெஃபினெட்லி.
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சந்தீப் மாத்தூர் சார், ஐ எம் டி கே ஸ்ரீவாஸ்தவ், ஹெட் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் பிஐடி.
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் மிஸ்டர் ஸ்ரீவாஸ்தவ்.
ஓகே சார்.
சார், वही तो ऐसे करिए लिखी डबल पॉइंट
थोड़ा रुक जाओ बेटा
बोल बोल
डीके सर आप डायरेक्टर सर को फोन कर लेंगे क्या?
ठीक है
हाँ क्योंकि एक्चुअली मैं मोबाइल से नेट चला रही हूँ ठीक है सर हो गई बात आपकी
बात हो गई ज्वाइनिंग जस्ट नाउ
जस्ट ओके सो विल यू रीनेम हिज आईडी फ्रॉम गैलेक्सी J7 प्राइम टू डायरेक्टर बीआईटी झांसी विल यू रीनेम हिज आईडी फ्रॉम गैलेक्सी J7 प्राइम टू बीआईटी झांसी डायरेक्टर बीआईटी झांसी Atul, I don't know. He is not responding. I have made you also co-host.
देखना पड़ेगा.
Dr. Atul, are you there?
Good afternoon, ma'am. I have joined.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. Yeah, good afternoon, sir. Just let me rename your ID. Okay, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Sandeep Mathur, sir, has joined, sir. Shall we start, sir? Anil, good sir, afternoon. Has not yet joined. Anil, sir.
Sure.
Good afternoon, sir. Director, sir, good afternoon.
Anil Kumar, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, kaise hain aap?
Bas badhiya, aap bataiye. How are you?
Anil sir has not joined yet, sir.
So we should wait or we should start?
Sir, director sir, I am operating through my mobile net. I request you if you can call him once, if possible.
Okay. Anil Kumar. हेलो
यस सर
हाँ मैडम आई हैड अ टॉक विद हिम ही इज ऑन हिज वे ही विल नॉट बी एबल टू ज्वाइन
ओके सर तो शैल वी कंटिन्यू सर
हाँ वी कैन कंटिन्यू
यस सर जस्ट लेट मी मेक यू को होस्ट एंड देन आई विल कंटिन्यू Am I audible, sir?
Audible, yes, ma'am. Yes.
A warm afternoon to all present here. The august gathering of renowned academicians, dear students, your excellency, and invited guests. Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. It is on occasions like this we get opportunities to share our knowledge and understanding. We look forward to get an exposure about what the best of the brains think about these very dynamic issues of current pandemic and technologies. Well, I, Shaina Sayub, shall be the host for this webinar. It is my great pleasure and the first and foremost duty on behalf of Bundelkhand Institute of Engineering and Technology and on my own behalf, I welcome Shri Sandeep Mathur sir, DRM Jhansi, our chief guest today. Professor V.K. Tyagi, Director, BIT Jhansi, Dr. Anil Kumar, State Project Administrator, SPIU, Uttar Pradesh, Dr. Mahavir Singh Naruka, Nodal Officer, Academic, SPIU, Uttar Pradesh, today's expert, Professor S. Mutton, Anna University, yeah. Chennai, our guest of honors today, Professor S. Raghavan, NIT Trichy, Professor V. Mahadevan, Senior Scientist, ISRO, Professor A.K. Nigam, TechCube Coordinator, BIT, Jhansi, Professor D.K. Srivastava, Head Electronics and Communication Engineering, BIT, Jhansi. All the members of SPIU team, all the members of my organizing team, and dear participants across the country from almost all states of our country who have joined through Zoom meeting platform, and all those who have joined through YouTube live streaming. I welcome you all to the third national webinar on transformations in electronics and communication engineering under the national webinar series on transformations in engineering and technologies started from 19th September, jointly organized by our institute, BIET Jhansi and State Project Implementation Unit Uttar Pradesh under Knowledge Transfer Series. I ensure that this webinar will be profitable and the next few hours will be enjoyable and enriched with experience for every one of you and will create some beautiful memories with knowledge and experience sharing by our expert and eminent guests. It is rightly said, things end, but memories last forever. Before proceeding further, as said correctly, leadership is the capacity to transform vision into reality. A good leader takes a little more than his share of the blame, a little less than his share of the credit. Yes, he does the same. I'm talking about a leader of this institute, a multi-talented personality, Honorable Director Professor V.K. Tyagi sir. Professor V.K. Tyagi sir is director at Bundelkhand Institute of Engineering and Technology, Jhansi, since 22nd December 2016. He is a well-known chemical technologist in India. Professor Tyagi, during his tenure as director of BIT Jhansi, has done good academic and infrastructure developments in the institute. His outstanding performances in academics, research, and administration have set a new benchmark for everyone in the field of engineering and technology. During his tenure, NBA has accredited 2 UG programs, Mechanical Engineering and Chemical Engineering, and others are under process. Professor V.K. Tyagi is continuously engaged in innovative teaching learning processes and encourages his subordinates too. I request you, sir, to take this platform and welcome the dignitaries and bless us with inaugural address on this wonderful occasion of intellectual gathering. Over to you, sir. Director sir, unmute yourself, sir.
Thank you, madam, for your kind words. First of all, I would like to welcome the chief guest of this function, Sri Sandeep Mathurji, DRM Jhansi, who exceeded our own. When I visited him first in his office and interacted with him, I came to know that he is from electronics engineering discipline. So at the time when it was planned, the webinar for today's topic.
Yes, sir.
It immediately came to my mind that Dr. Sri Mathur will be the right choice as a chief guest for this particular webinar. And I'm really thankful from the core of my heart that Mr. Mathur accepted our invitation and ready to inaugurate this function as a chief guest and to address the August gathering. I know that he's have done a tremendous work in the railway, particularly with respect to the transmission, with respect to the signals, with respect to the communication, and lot many. So his experience will definitely be benefited to our participants, which have gathered over here from across the nation. I am thankful to state project administrator, although I just contacted him and he is on his way. He is not in a position to join this webinar. I am thankful to state project administrator and his team for continuously supporting for the cause of the academics during this pandemic. I am thankful to the experts. I welcome all the experts who have joined over here. I know that there are certain experts who are our chief guests in the last function. They liked our function like this, that they informed madam that they will also be a part of this webinar, because this is all because of their sheer interest in the academics and the transformation of the knowledge with respect to the transformation which is being taking place in during this pandemic. As you all are aware that since last 7 or 8 months, the life has been paralyzed across the globe. Particularly, academics has suffered a lot, right from the primary education to secondary education to the professional education. There is a lot of disturbances, and new approaches, new platforms of the learnings are being explored, and their merits and demerits are being discussed at different platforms, and what best can be done under the situation is being a brainstorming is taking place on those issues, and we are coming with certain solutions, because as you all are aware that engineers are the community who believes in providing the solutions to the problems related to the society. So during this pandemic, we have chosen the topic, the transformations in engineering and technologies, and we are selecting one discipline on every Saturday. On last two Saturdays, we had webinar on the chemical engineering transformations, then computer science, and now this is the turn of the transformations which are being taking place in the area of the electronics and communication engineering. So, because our ultimate aim is that how we can provide the benefit of the technology to the society, to the stakeholders, by way of providing the solutions during this pandemic. As you all are aware that electronics is basically a backbone of number of the technologies which are associated with it. When we talk about the benefit of the artificial intelligence to the health sector, to the energy sector, then definitely the electronics engineering comes into the picture. So I'm not basically man from the electronics engineering, but definitely the our chief guest will throw certain light on what new is taking place in the area, what are the future possibilities which can be explored. Our educationists, our academicians, our researchers will also be benefited by tips which he will be providing in his address to the August gathering. I am confident that the participants who have gathered over here will be definitely benefited by the experts' opinions and the chief guest's opinion, and they will come up with the solution for which the engineers are meant. With these words, I congratulate the organizers for holding this activity under the knowledge transfer series, which is being organized by Bundelkhand Institute of Engineering and Technology in association with State Project Implementation Unit, Uttar Pradesh. With these words, I welcome all the participants who are going to attend this webinar and wish a success for this webinar. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you very much, sir, for your motivation, guidance, and moral support. Your influence can never be erased, sir. The pessimist complains about the wind. The optimist expects it is to change. The leader adjusts the sails. Your motivational presence matters a lot to us, sir. Thank you, sir, for being us with on this beautiful day, occasion of this webinar. Thank you very much, sir. Going ahead, let me shortly take you to the agenda. The webinar has two sessions, inaugural session where we are currently, and then the technical session. As Dr. Anil Kumar is not here in this webinar, we will be blessed with chief guest address by Shri Sandeep Mathur, sir, Honorable DRM Jhansi. Professor A.K. Nigam, TechIP Coordinator BIT Jhansi, will propose vote of thanks of this inaugural session. Afterwards, it will be followed by technical session, technical keynote talk on transformations in electronics and communication engineering will be delivered by Professor S. Muttan, sir, Department of Electronics and Engineering, Anna University, Chennai. Our guest of honors today, Professor V. Mahadevan, Senior Scientist, ISRO, and Professor S. Raghavan, NIT Trichy, will share their views. Then the session will be open for question and answers. Feedback link will be given in chat box. Questions can also be put up in chat box, which will be taken care by us to resolve through expert. At last, Professor D.K. Srivastava, Head Electronics and Communication Engineering, BIT Jhansi, will propose vote of thanks. Leaders are by definition change makers, that is transformers. When you are called to lead, you are called to advance, move forward, and improve the situation. Yes, we have such a successful leader. The whole digital platform is vibrating and echoing his prominence. Chief guest of this webinar, Shri Sandeep Mathur, Honorable DRM Jhansi. Sir, you hardly need any introduction. You have made all of us proud to be citizen of Jhansi by your distinguished work as DRM Jhansi, a man of signaling, a technocrat, and inspiration to all of us. He is a man who looks forward to reform the railway sector with the aid of technology. Shri Sandeep Mathur, Honorable DRM Jhansi, and a well-known expert and technologist of signals in the country. Shri Sandeep Mathur has established and transformed the railway sector with good governance, which he only can do. He is a man of automation. Shri Sandeep Mathur has served as signal and telecommunication engineer in numerous capacities in Indian Railways divisions of Bikaner, Delhi, Prayagraj, Chakradharpur, etc. It is his disabilities and expertization that he was sent to Malaysia as a signal expert. Then after, he contributed immensely on automatic train protection system in Indian Rail Research and Design Wing in RDSO. During his tenure as DRM Jhansi, he expedited the work of third line in Dholpur-Bina section, work of doubling in Jhansi-Kanpur section. during his tenure, the electrification work in Jhansi, Manikpur and Bhimsen Bandha rail divisions was completely under his was completed under his able guidance. The train speed has raised to 130 km per hour in main line of Dhalpur-Bina section of Jhansi division and 110 km per hour in Jhansi-Manikpur section of Jhansi division during his tenure as DRM Jhansi. Under his able guidance and leadership, the mechanical signaling in the division is transformed to latest electronic signaling. He is a man of rail transformations. Also, in Jhansi-Manikpur section, the old signaling is replaced by electronic signaling except Manikpur, Mauranipur station. Now, in this line, the trains are running with a speed of 110 km per hour instead of 15 km per hour. During his tenure, almost on all stations of division, the Wi-Fi facility is rendered to all travelers. Apart from this, the CCTV camera systems are improved in Jhansi and Gwalior stations, and CCTV cameras are installed on Bandha station. The work is in progress at Lalitpur and Urai stations. During this lockdown, Sri Sandeep Mathur sir has played important role in successful operation of Shramik special trains. There are n number of achievements in his credit, and had justified his role with efficiency. I request you, sir, to take this digital platform and fulfill our knowledge. We are honored to listen to your insightful speech as chief guest address to motivate this galaxy of intellectuals. Sir, over to you, sir.
Good afternoon. And first of all, thanks, Dr. Shahnaz, for such nice words. Professor Tyagi, Director BIET, Dr. Shahnaz, other professors from BIET and Chennai, Trichy, and from all over India. What I am told that we have a lot of experts today on this. It is extreme pleasure for me to be on this forum among the learned academicians and students after around 30 odd years. I did my BTech and subsequently MTech and joined railways in 1990 when I left my studies. So it has been 30 long years after which I have been amongst such sort of a gathering. The subject today is very close to my heart because, as already Dr. Shahnaz and Director Mr. Tyagi has told, that I have a background of electronics and communications. And very proudly, I can say that in today's world, no other engineering is independent. They all are based on the platform of electronics and communication. You go to any other field, you will need electronics and communication, and no other engineering can work without electronics and without communication. Electronics and communication, today they go hand in hand, and you cannot assume communication without electronics, and you cannot think of electronics without communication. 30 years back when I joined Indian Railways, so that time, I think today people are, students are not very keen to join administrative services and central government services. They are more keen towards private jobs, but that time these jobs were very important jobs and people used to go after them. And when I joined Indian Railways, with electronics and signaling background, and we, the very first day we landed in our institute.
Sorry, sir, I request all the participants to please mute yourself. Sir, please, sir, continue.
Yeah, definitely. So when I joined there, and in the first few days, that those times, all the signaling was on mechanical base, and in the first 3 months, we were so frustrated that having a background of electronics and telecommunication, we were amongst mechanical things, mechanical signaling, and everything around us was mechanical. Not to say anything bad about mechanical field, but we, being from electronics and communication and forced to do mechanical and study mechanical, so we were a bit frustrated. But never we knew that time that we will be the people who will be transforming Indian Railways from mechanical to electronics. And the signaling platform will shift from mechanical signaling to electronics. We never knew that Indian Railways will be providing Wi-Fi to all these stations, even in the remotest past, on optical fiber backbone, and the communication to each and every small city of India. Now we have almost around 5,000 stations covering all over India on Wi-Fi networks. So just to add on it, all this I'm telling is, when you join a particular service, you never know that how things will transform. Before in 90s and all, before 2000, no one ever thought that we'll be so dependent on mobile. No one even could have thought of a life without mobile, and we used to work round the clock. 24/7 service is Indian Railways. We used to work without a mobile. And today, the new probationers who are joining us, who are joining Indian Railways, they can't even think about life without a mobile, how to be in touch with everyone without a mobile. So the electronics and the communication platform and the people who all are there today, I feel that this, you need to be very proud of being a part of electronics and communication field. And even today, a field which is slightly being thought of above it is computer, but computer science also is based on electronics and telecommunication. Let me tell you, the computers and computer science cannot live without electronics and communication. Computers are based on electronics and communication. Computer hardware is electronics, and computer amongst themselves can talk only communication. There. In today's world, I'll just share with you that Indian Railways has also kept a pace with electronics and communication development. No one will be able to see from outside, because for arm public, for everyone else, the Indian Railways is train running on track. You can see the track, you can see a driver driving a electric loco, you can see coaches which run on track, and nowhere do you feel that you see electronics, you see communication around. But these trains, they run on signaling system, which is, as on date, all converted to electronics. By a click of mouse, you can lower signals on a station. By the communication network, which Indian Railways have its own communication network, the various drivers, various stations communicate to our central control. And on top of it all, Indian Railways are now going on for indigenized automatic train control systems, wherein if a driver misses a signal, and a red signal he misses and he overshoots it, then the electronics in the loco will automatically bring the train to a halt. So such is the level of electronics which is slowly coming into Indian Railways. So we have all, at all stations, you already know, you must be aware that we now have Wi-Fi. Almost even at the smallest of these stations, now we are going for Wi-Fi, which is on the backbone of an optical fiber done by Indian Railways themselves. So electronics and telecommunications are deep inside Indian Railways. Recently, as Professor Tyagi also mentioned about the pandemic and the situation wherein we all were landed, where we could not see each other, we could not meet each other, but for the needs of the country, for the needs of the countrymen, Indian Railways never stopped. Though we say this was the first time when Indian Railways was brought to a halt. This was the first time when Indian Railways was brought to a halt, but it was only passenger. Let me tell you, it was only passenger traveling which was brought to a halt. The goods trains were continuously on the move. Though in April and May, the number of goods trains were less, but to transport the daily necessities, the medical needs, the wheat, the rice, to run the thermal power plants, the coal, Indian Railways never stopped. We were always on the roll, but at the same time, there were a lot of issues for us because we could not meet each other, we could not see each other, but still we had to run trains. And there is then what you come as like, you find positives from this negative of pandemic. And two very important positives which came out of this pandemic from Indian Railways. We had an e-office platform, which is an electronic platform for movements of files instead of a physical file, wherein we were very used to physical files, paper, signing, but very quickly we all transformed ourselves as per the need, and we started using e-office, electronic office, wherein files now are being dealt by us on electronic platform. There are no hard files now being used, only very less which are very important, like drawings and all, which we are not able to right now convert on e-office platform. So this electronics again came to our rescue, and we started use of e-office. So this was one very important aspect which started. And the second, which of course we are now doing right now, as Director BIT Tyagi Saab also said, that this Zoom meetings, Zoom conferences, they were nowhere to be seen before this pandemic. And this this pandemic only forced us and brought us on this platform, and now all the meetings, internal as well as external meetings on Indian Railways, we are doing on this platform, either on Zoom or WebEx or whatever. There are so many now. There are so many platforms. So these are the positives which come out of negative. Our Honorable Prime Minister also said one day that we need to be not pessimistic, but we need to find positives from this also. And this is one of the platform which again electronics and communication have come together, and the computers have been utilized for such a innovative thing like meetings and conferences on this platform. Though to certain extent they were in use, but to the extent which we are now using them, I don't think anyone will disagree with me that this is a very positive aspects coming out of it. Previously, when we used to have meeting, physical meetings, a lot of time they were attended by people who were not able to take decisions because they were representatives of many parties. But now when we take a meeting, and when the top level CEOs of the companies are able to join those meetings on WebEx or on Zoom or any other platform being used, a very positive and a synergy comes into play and a lot of decisions are taken very fast. So electronics and telecommunication, let me tell you, are backbone of all this thing, and they have come to the rescue of each and every one of us during this pandemic. And who all are there today, they must definitely be feeling proud to be associated with electronics and communication. And I wish every one of you, each of you, that this webinar should be a very successful one, and we'll be able to hear experts today, and which will be very useful. Even in organizations like railways, where you don't see electronics actually, you should let me tell you that it is each and every, even the train loco, it is learning on electronics. Even the wagons and coaches, now we are putting electronics in them so that we can monitor. You must have heard about a new train, that is train 18, the train 18 which was inaugurated last year, that the whole braking system is based on electronics. So electronics and communication as well. You cannot have all the coaches communicating together. The braking system, it is very calculated braking, which improves the running of the train. It does calculate, and the performance goes tremendously high. The braking goes very nicely and smoothly. So electronics and communication are into us through all the aspects. Okay, whatever you can feel around you, electronics and communication is there. So all the best to everyone, and thank you, Dr. Tyagi, for letting me be on this forum. And it is a very nice feeling to be amongst you, our learned academicians and students who will be greatly advantaged by this webinar. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mahathir sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. The quality of a leader is reflected in the standards they set for themselves, and sir is among them. He made our city, our state, our country to feel proud. Sir, I wholeheartedly thank you for your inspiring and encouraging words. We wish to express our gratitude to you, sir, for being with us on this event. Thank you very much, sir. Your thought-provoking address set a perfect platform for us on this important topic of today's webinar. Thank you, sir.
I'll be continuing with you all. I'll be greatly interested in what all being discussed. Maybe meeting. Yes, in between, sir. Maybe I move out, but as on right now, I'll be continuing with you all.
Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
It will be our pleasure, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Prior to move ahead with technical session, I would request Professor A.K. Nigam, TechUp Coordinator, BIT Jhansi, to propose vote of thanks of this inaugural session.
Thank you, madam. Good evening to all the dignitaries, experts, organizing team, and participants. It is my pleasure to be a part of this webinar. In this webinar, today's chief guest, Mr. Sandeep Mathur, DRM Jhansi, who has given his valuable time and consent to become chief guest, is really appreciable. And his words are very inspiring, as he told that in the last 30 years, how he has seen how the real transformation he has placed in signaling. Definitely, his further association will be benefited. This will be give benefit to the listeners. Now, BIT is really thankful to you, sir. I am also thankful to Professor Muthan from Anna University, Chennai, who is going to deliver talk in this webinar. Definitely, this talk will not be beneficial, but will give various thoughts to implement and found solutions to various problems. Sir, many, many thanks to you for accepting our invitation for expert talk. At the same time, I am thankful to Professor Raghavan from NIT Trichy and Professor V. Mahadevan, senior scientist, ISRO, for accepting our invitation and sharing their views about transformations in electronics and communication engineering. Thank you, sir. At this time, we cannot forget TechCube 3, which has pressed us to do such events. In this connection, SPIU Lucknow is also playing an important role, especially Dr. Anil Kumar and his team, which is very hardworking and always available for guiding and resolving our problems. BIT is thankful to Dr. Anil Kumar and Dr. Mahavir Singh Naruka. I am also thankful to our director, Professor V.K. Tyagi, who is always encouraging and providing all type of supports for upliftment of the academic. I am also thankful to Head Electronics and Communication Engineering, Professor D.K. Srivastava, and Dr. Shahnaz Ayub, Dean R&D and coordinator of this webinar series, who have come forward and did lot of work to organize this webinar. Last but not the least, we all are thankful to all the participants without whom any event cannot achieve success. With these words, I wish great success to this webinar. Once again, I pay thanks to all who are contributing to this webinar directly or indirectly. Thank you. Madam, over to you.
Let me thank Professor A.K. Nigam for his wonderful cooperation to this webinar and webinar series. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Is to see what everybody else has seen and to think what nobody else has thought yet. Yes, we have a great researcher and academician, our expert today, Professor S. Muthan from Anna University, Chennai. Dr. S. Muthan is presently professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, College of Engineering, Guindy, Anna University, Chennai. He had been the former regional director, Tiruchirappalli, besides holding several important positions, such as director of Indian Institute of Information Technology, Srirangam, dean of Bharati Dasan Institute of Technology, Tiruchirappalli, additional director, constituent colleges, former head, Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, and former director, Center for Medical Electronics, Deputy Director, Center for Affiliations, Deputy Director, Anna University, Sports Board, Deputy Registrar, Finance, and Finance Officer in charge of Anna University, Chennai. He is currently the coordinator, National Hub for Healthcare Instrumentation, a unique hub with the support from DST, Government of India, dedicated to the design and development of indigenous medical devices in India, collaborating with IISc, IITs, universities, reputed national research labs, industries, and hospitals under the aegis of NHID and UPE, many medical gadgets were designed, developed, and fabricated, manufactured with limited manufacturing capability available at Anna University and commercialized with successful technology transferred to industries. Anna University has the distinction of being awarded the coveted status of university with potential for excellence in biomedical engineering and instrumentation by UGC among all the Indian universities with an allocation of rupees 25 crores. Professor S. Muthan was chosen to lead this prestigious scheme in the capacity of coordinator. Under UPE scheme, national platforms in cutting-edge technologies such as bioscience, optoelectronics, medical imaging, limited manufacturing in mechanical, electronic system design and instrumentation were established. which together is capable of making an industry-ready commercial healthcare device, a forerunner for making India concept. Under United Kingdom, India Education and Research Initiative, in collaboration with Westminster University as academic partner and MS Appasamy Associates Chennai, a pioneer in ophthalmic instruments, Professor Muttan has successfully developed MobScope, a portable microscope attached to a mobile phone, which could be used to identify malarial parasites from blood samples. He has been the principal investigator in many funded projects, namely wireless sensor networks applied to telemedicine, design and development of web-based online telehealth consultancy system, web-based audiometer, low-cost mobile-based automatic malaria detection, sponsored by United Kingdom under UKD, NHHID by DST and UPE by UGC. Funds totaling to the tune of rupees 35 crores. He was instrumental in promoting awareness among the clinicians regarding calibration of medical devices, and with the establishment of Center for Calibration of Critical Care Equipment, had spearheaded a team which calibrated over 10,000 medical equipments from 200 hospitals during a period of last 3 to 4 years. He is a life member of Indian Association of Biomedical Scientists, Biomedical Society of India, ISTE, Computer Society of India, Indian Association for Medical Informatics, and more. He has over 35 years of teaching and research experience with more than 75 national and international publications in reputed journals. He has delivered more than 100 invited lectures in national and international forums. Today, Sir will deliver on transformations in electronics and communication engineering, the very topic of this webinar. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Good evening to all of you. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Yes, sir.
At the outset, I would like to thank Professor V.K. Tyagi, Director BIT Jhansi. Also, my respects to Sri Sandeep Mathur, DRM Jhansi, Dr. Anil Kumar, State Project Administrator, Dr. Shahana Ayub. Good evening, madam.
Good evening, sir.
Professor A.K. Nigam and Professor D.K. Srivatsa, Professor Raghavan, one of my finest colleague, Professor V. Mahadevan, and all those who are right now listening to this webinar. Good evening to all of you. In fact, I am very pleased to be associated with this national webinar series on transformations in engineering and technologies. I understand that this is the third webinar in continuation on transformations in electronics and communication engineering under a knowledge transfer series. And it has been a wonderful opportunity to meet all of you through this webinar. And I am waiting for such a beautiful opportunity. Thanks to Professor Raghavan, who in fact facilitated this opportunity for me. Madam, if everything is ready, can I go for presentation?
Yes, sir. You are co-host, so you can share your screen, sir.
Yeah, madam. Okay. Idhu vendam, idhu minimize panikkalama. Is the screen visible, madam, to all of
the
participants?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
It is the first slide, title slide, Transformations in Electronics
and Communication. Thank you.
Yes,
thank you. So good evening, all the delegates. In fact, this topic was quite interesting. Transformations of electronics and communication engineering. So what we see in front of this slide is a huge rock I mean, standing gigantically, mostly insignificant. And when it is chiseled, it becomes a beautiful temple. That is transformations. Transformations are architects of future. In fact, when you look at this beautiful temple, we see only the macro picture. But what is real transformation is, we have to appreciate transformations at all levels, be it nano level or micro level or milli level, all macro level. Unless we understand transformations at each level, I think we will not be able to appreciate the transformations at the macro level. Before really getting into the topic, I would like to go through a few slides on education and how do people see this term education. Swami Vivekananda very beautifully defines education as, education is the manifestation of perfection already existing in man and woman. There is another beautiful definition of education. Education is one that remains in all our mind after having forgotten everything that you have learned. So even after many decades, if you are able to keep something in your mind, that is real education. That is the real process of learning. So education is one that remains in your mind after having forgotten everything that you have learned, is another beautiful definition of education. Dear friends, education is that which tells us how much we do not know rather than how much we know. In fact, education is infinity. After listening to a wonderful lecture from an eminent speaker, there are two ways of expressing our pleasure. One is, oh, what a wonderful lecture. How much I have learned, how much I got benefited. There is always another way of expressing the same pleasure, stating that, what a wonderful lecture. How much I was ignorant on this. How much things I did not know. So this is the way that education makes us create an awareness, an awakening, which says that real education makes us to understand that rather than knowing, we do not know much. In this connection, Albert Einstein beautifully puts these things in right perspective. Two things are infinite. One is the universe, and second is the human stupidity. And he goes on to say that, I'm sure about the universe, which means human stupidity is still there. Education, I hear, I forget. I see, I remember. I do, I understand. More so, education is really imagination. Imagination is more powerful than knowledge. Education should be learned only through more and more imagination. Be open-minded like a child. Don't get stigmatized with the mistakes. In theory, dear friends, there is no difference between theory and practice. But in practice, really, there is a difference. In theory, everything looks so beautiful like a meadow. But when you really step in, it's a hard rock like what you see here. Further, transformations in every field has been happening. It's not just in mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electronics engineering, computer science, IT, whatsoever, be the field of subject. In every area, every field where man gets into, things are happening, transformations are happening. So behind all these transformations, we have extraordinary evidence of human creativity. And behind this extraordinary evidence of human creativity, we do have extraordinary unpredictability. In spite of having so much knowledge, so much big data behind us, it is next to impossible to predict what is going to happen after 50 years. And this extraordinary human creativity, when it continues to progress, the continuity of creativity, lifelong learning, really brings in the beautiful transformations that every technology comes on its way. Further, these transformations are, in fact, outcome of inventions and innovations. Inventions are creation of new products. Innovations are changes that happen in an existing product. A wheel is an invention, but a motorcycle, the wheel of a car is an innovation. Again, a few more examples of this invention and evolution, innovation is Alexander Graham Bell has come out with a beautiful invention called phone in 1876. But you can see the different avatars of this cell phone right in front of you. The evolution of a telephone right from the oldest model to the latest model, right from the unifunctional to multifunctional cell phone today. What you see right now in front of you is again the world's first computer, so huge, so many wires in front of you. But today, all this come to a standstill and you have a very small miniaturized handheld computer. What else you can hope for? The world's biggest computer, which occupies many square meters, have now come with a small few centimeters. And behind this, you have wonderful discoveries, inventions, transformations do happen because of discoveries and inventions. Creativity is a very important component of this transformation. Creativity again comes out of two kinds of thinking, the critical thinking and the creative thinking. The ability to see the problems in several dimensions and the ability to truly understand the problem on hand is what is really creativity. Science is behind this creativity. The pursuit of knowledge, primary goal is knowledge, engineering, technology, and the design, all of them put together is what is transformation. Again, I'm making clear about the discovery, invention, innovation. I have given a few examples. Penicillin is a discovery. Light bulb and the relativity is an invention. Retail store is an innovation. And we have many more innovations such as this. These are all types of innovations. The world has seen many and many innovations, many inventions, many discoveries, and wonderful to live in this beautiful world. Dear friends, if everything is under control, which means we are not progressing. So if everything is under control, you are not just driving fast enough. You have to work hard. You have to do homework. You have to do hard work. You have to do smart work. You have to do teamwork. You have to do network. Successful innovation, invention, discovery is not some of the combinations of these two, but the sum of all these combinations create the wonderful world. Sorry. Now coming to the real topic. In fact, what I would like to tell you is that as we have seen the example of a rock becoming a temple, its past, present, and future manifestations, all of them we have to appreciate. So today I would like to develop my lecture, so webinar series on three important things. That is electronics, its manifestation in 19th century, the great scientist who lived in that during that period, the manifestation in 20th century, and its manifestation in 21st century, and its evolutions. All these things, let me try to put my best to you. I'm sure I enjoyed preparing these slides, and this is one of my most lovable topic, because as our Chief Guest rightly said, electronics and communication engineering is all pervading. Evolution of electronics. J.J. Thomson won a Nobel Prize for discovering this tiny particle in 1897. And interestingly, Sun again got Nobel Prize after 40 years for proving the wavelength structures of electron. A mere century ago, no one had ever heard of an electron. But now there is hardly a person who has not heard something about it. It's always the hero, despite the fact that it carries a negative charge. What is disheartening in the process is that long, long back, amber rod rubbed with wool attracted light objects discovered by weavers in the 6th century. But unfortunately, dear friends, right up to the 18th century, not a single attempt was made to look deeper into this phenomena. So almost 12 centuries have been lost, and nothing appreciable was obtained. uh, And what you see here is always there is an electron, but anything presented in front of you has to go through series of fundamental questions. That is where all the transformation comes. What is an electron? What is an electric charge? How does it move? Why does it move? How do we know electric charge exists? What is electronics? And finally, the more basic question, the more basic is the question, the more difficult it is to answer. That's why I always prefer, my dear colleagues and friends, I love to have children of 3 years and 4 years old in my class because they're bold enough to ask questions. But all my respectable students, undergraduate, postgraduate, never open their mouth. I think this is not the time. You have to ask questions. Question is the fundamental to transformations. Questioning attitude is most important. I would like to put forth a few facts of electrons. No one has ever seen an electron, naturally, even J.J. Thompson or anybody. Till today, I have been trying, I have not seen an electron. But thank God, I'm getting a huge, big, fat salary talking about electron. Its radius is 4 into 10 times 10 to the power of 11 times smaller than a millimeter. It's too small. The mass of an electron is 10 power 27 times less than a milligram. The charge is 1.6 into 10 power 19. The charge and mass of a single electron are so small that no one could really look at it. But my dear friends, let me tell you, electron never works alone. It's a typical example of wonderful teamwork. The speed of it moves with the speed of light, 3 kilometers per second. 1 ampere of current, please understand, needs 63 into 10 power 17 electrons per second. Unless so many electrons flows per second, your ammeter will not measure 1 ampere. If, imagine in 1 second, your body is given 1 million electrons, almost 10 lakh electrons. If your body receives 10 lakh electrons in 1 second, a charge of 1 coulomb will be accumulated in 200 years. But this is not being done, I understand. But you have to understand that so many particles are needed to build up 1 coulomb of charge. So in 1 second, if 10 lakh charges are accumulated, it needs 200 years for completion of this. And finally, I'd like to share with you the wonderful characteristics of an electron. In fact, I feel electron is my God. It has no wear and tear. It's too small, as you have seen. It's light and mobile. The speed of this electron is almost 3 lakh kilometers per second. It goes through any medium, be it solid or liquid or semiconductor, any kind of medium it can go through. And it can give 1 milliampere of current. It can give 10 milliampere of current. It can even give 1 ampere of current. It is a repository of electrons. It works as a team with no fear or favor. Whether I put my finger or Donald Trump, the shock will be there. It respects none. So no fear or favor. And the wonderful quality of this is today, the father of our nation is Mahatma Gandhi. Yesterday was October 2nd. Because he was the one who was selfless, never took rest, always in motion. Dandi Yatra, he begins walking fast. And I see a lot of similarities of the great personalities of Mahatma Gandhi and others with the electron. Electron also never takes rest. It is ready to serve the humanity. In fact, 24/7 times. Then what else can be a best service provider in this world, in this era, than this wonderful shiny particle called electron? That is why, my dear friends, this age is called age of electronics. Let all the electronics engineers be proud of this statement. Today, all the services are done by this small tiny particle electron. Without this, there is no service at all. Therefore, I'm very proud, and I think everyone will agree with me that this is the age of electronics. Coming to a few definitions of electronics. Yeah, electronics is defined as control the flow of electrons and deals with circuits, components, flow of electricity, and it's a part of physics, electrical engineering, and also electrical circuits involving active electric components such as vacuum tubes, transistors, diodes, integrated circuits, optoelectronics, a lot of things like that. So these are some of the conventional definition of electronics, but now I would like to introduce to you some of the aesthetic and some of the metaphysical definitions of electronics. Electronics can also be defined like this. I hope all of you are aware that we have five senses. Sensory organs, eye, ear, nose, skin, and tongue. Electronics is an extension of these human senses. You have television, vision is extended. Telephone, hearing capabilities extended, and speaking capabilities extended. And you have, see for example, nose. You have today e-nose. Skin, yeah, you can have the feeling of skin, the haptic devices are there. E-tongue is available, which means electronics so profound today that there is no place where there is no electronics. Electronics definition, wonderful definition I really came across is electronics is an extension of human senses because all the five senses are being extended. Also, dear friends, what I have given you is exactly the same thing which I was trying to tell you. Extension of human senses. You see, there is a human eye, there is an electronic eye. There is a human nose, there is an electronic nose. There is a human tongue, there is an e-tongue. There is a skin, yeah, there is a haptic device which can touch and feel. And there is a ear, and you have the earphone. So electronics, the definition is extension of human senses, is more fit functionally than conventional definition of electronics because it is close to our lives. Also, we have been talking about in India about Panchabhutas, the five elements, fire, air, earth, water, ether. I think electronics is almost close to conquering this. Electronics has fusion with these five Panchabhutas. So perfect balancing the five elements of our daily life. So I think with all these kinds of visualizations and perspectives of electronics, I think we are very, very blessed to live in this world along with electron and communications. Electronics also, my dear friends and colleagues, can be visualized and defined as a evolution of sources, evolution of channels, and evolution of receivers, because fundamentally, the term electronics and communication means that an information is transmitted from place A to place B through a particular channel. So there's a source, and there is a channel, and there's a receiver. So electronics is also defined as evolution of sources, evolution of channels, and evolution of receivers. So in a nutshell, I would like to share with all of you that the transformation that we have been talking about in electronics and communication engineering also includes the transformation do happen in electronic sources. Many transformations have happened in channels, and many, many transformations are happening in receivers. So electronics, other beautiful definition is evolution of electronic sources, channels, and receivers. As an example to make my thoughts very clear to you, I have given you a small table here. These are all sources, electronic sources, classification of oscillators. So you can see that from RC phase shift oscillator, Hartley oscillator, crystal oscillators, and then you have GUNN diode, reflex klystron, and then laser, maser on increase of frequencies. In fact, this is the evolution of sources. This is the transformation that has happened in the source of generating signals in the case of electronics. So audio frequency oscillators, radio frequency oscillators, very high frequency oscillators, ultra high frequency oscillator, microwave oscillator, and multi-wave oscillator. So you can see the transformations. I'm trying to make you understand the transformations not at macro level. At macro level, everybody agrees that electronics has really made a lot of strides into every field, every walks of life. You name any field, as the chief guest really rightly pointed out, absolutely without electronics, there'd be no progress. But however, within electronics and communications, subdivisions, smaller divisions, which also has to be taken care so that we really understand the macro transformations. Coming to the communication channels, again, there are very, very many transformations. So communication channels again can be thought as wired channels, wireless channels. If you see the transformations in wired channel, you have twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optical cable. Under wireless communication, you have microwave communication, radio communication, satellite communication. So if you really see, transformations doesn't happen superficially. Every nano level and every pico level, things has to happen. Then only at the top surface, you will see wonderful transformations happening. And electronics, in fact, the transformation has happened at every level of interfacing. These are some of the examples that I have been talking about. Copper twisted pair is one avatar of communication channel, wired communication channel. Then came coaxial cable, another avatar. Then you have the optical fiber, today's new avatar. And you have the waveguides, rectangular waveguides and circular waveguides for microwave communication. And let me tell you that our forefathers who lived during 1900s were really great. Today, many of us talk through cell phone. We enjoy the conversation, we enjoy the music, but none of us really see who carries them to us because they're all invisible waves. But the greatness of those people who lived much, much earlier to us, being in the 8th, 19th century or 20th century, they have really gone. That's what I tell you, knowledge is imagination. Imagination is more powerful than knowledge. Long waves. The world is consisting of long waves, medium waves, short waves, ultra short waves. Then you have TV band, radar, klystron communication, etc. Let me tell you, dear friends, the history of electronics, the transformations of electronics doesn't stop at these very many definitions I have given. There is another definition where electronics can be added. The history of electronics is, in essence, the history of shortening of wavelengths, because it is this wavelength, it is this frequency, which is the beginning source. Because of the inventions of these very many sources of frequencies, shortening of high frequency, shortening of wavelengths, the channel has changed. We have moved from twisted pair wire to coaxial cable to optical fibers, and then wireless communication. Then you have ionospheric communication. So many concepts have come. You have like a wave propagation and the antenna design. All this is because of the long waves, medium waves, short waves, ultra short waves. Therefore, let us not forget that transformations have also happened in the area of shortening of wavelengths. So, in fact, many waves do come from space, and you have the ionosphere, and there are many questions. In fact, these are very interesting facts anyhow. I hope this PowerPoint presentation will be available in the net for you. You can go through. There are many, many confusions that exist a long back. A word spoken in Europe could be heard throughout Australia, whereas a game played in Moscow cannot be reaching just 150 kilometers. Even though the TV has seen the surface of the moon for the first time, which is 384,000 kilometers away. There were some very, very inconvenient questions those days. And to understand this, people have imagined that ionosphere like a billiard. So this is what people have imagined, which means this is what is called the sixth sense or seventh sense of human being. Ordinary people cannot imagine these things. And our forefathers, excellent people, they have seen all these things. And today we have this wireless communication. So this is what exactly they have done. You can see this is called the billiard of the ionosphere. This such kind of propagation, this is one receiver. There are two receivers. They are very much far away. In spite of that, through ionospheric propagation of such nature, what I'm trying to show you, people could receive. But to visualize this, to imagine this, you need the mind of a genius. So this is again a great transformation. Just to tell you about the value of energy, the difference between sound and electromagnetic wave, the sound energy of 1 lakh people speaking simultaneously just does not exceed the energy of a consumed lamp or flashlight. Sound of energy of the people in the whole world does not exceed that of an engine of a small car. And what you see here, my dear friends, is very many series of wireless communication. This is a great transformation that has happened over the years. Satellite communication, infrared communication, broadcast communication, microwave communication, Wi-Fi, wireless technology in medical field, wireless power transfer. So you can see that transformations have been happening in every subsections in nano level and pico level of electronics and communication engineering. So it is just not a superficial topic. And as we dig more and more, the treasure is higher and higher. And you can see the transformations have also happened in terms of communication receivers. microstrip antennas, very many antennas. You have many varieties of antennas for various purposes. You have the aperture antennas and paraboloid antennas, and then you have the strip antenna, and they use it in many areas. So these are some of the examples of antennas being used. So this is what I mean by, again, transformations. Transformations in electronics and communication has happened in every field. I think all of us have studied 45 different topics of electronics in our undergraduate courses, or maybe around 15 courses on PG postgraduate. You tell me which, you take a single page in a single textbook, I think that's a transformation in that line of, in any line of that single page of the textbook. You take hundreds and thousands of textbooks related to electronics, you choose any page, and in that page, you can see one line. In every line, you can see great transformations. So that is the greatness of transformations in electronics and communication engineering. This Boeing has more than 20 to 25 types of antennas for various purposes. Coming back slowly to actual transformations in a different angle, transformations also did happen in human history. Many, many revolutions have happened. We are more interested in age of revolution from 1765 to 1864. American Revolution, French Revolution, Haitian Revolution, so many revolutions have taken place. All these revolutions have taken place for rights, equality, so many things. These were all fought for human beings. Many more revolutions also did take in other related sectors. You have Black Revolution, Blue Revolution, Brown Revolution, whatnot. There's a huge list of revolutions. Petroleum production, fish production, then you have oil seed production. So revolutions have happened in human improvement for increasing the human rights, civil activists, and then for equality, fraternity. French Revolution stands for that. And also in industrial sectors, many revolutions happen. Green Revolution has happened. White Revolution has happened. All these things are happening. But let us talk about revolutions that also happened in technology. In fact, there were four technological revolutions that has happened. Fundamentally, it starts with the Industrial Revolution in the year 1800, 1784. Industrial Revolution was mechanical in nature. Mechanical production with the help of water and steam power, many things were achieved. Whereas Industrial Revolution, second Industrial Revolution became electromechanical. The third Industrial Revolution became almost electronics, IT oriented, and then it's ICT and cyber-based physical systems. So what you can see is, no doubt, revolutions have been happening in every dimension of human life. As we are all technologists and engineers, we are more bothered about probably a revolution that has happened in our own field, namely the engineering and technology. In the field of engineering technology, Industrial Revolution 1 has happened, which has enhanced the mechanical production productivity, but the Industrial Revolution did not stop there. Subsequently, there were three revolutions. Therefore, totally, there were four Industrial Revolutions, first, second, third, and fourth. Each one was more complex than the previous one. That's what this picture shows. It has happened over the last almost 200 years, two centuries, we have seen this. And today, we are in the fourth revolution, where everything would happen through electronics. So first Industrial Revolution was steam-based machines. Second Industrial Revolution, 19th century to 20th century, electrical, electromechanical. Third Industrial Revolution is first information technology revolution in the late 20th century, computer-based, internet-based knowledge. And along with this came the wonderful words like artificial intelligence, information technology, then big data, IoT, blockchain. Let us not forget that the terms may look like embedded software-like, but behind this huge, there's a huge layer of electronics. So it is the electronics, it is the processor which does all these things. Therefore, I have included this. And the fourth Industrial Revolution, which is second information revolution, is happening right now in front of us, and it is the 21st century revolution. Let me again tell that these four revolutions, as we really look deep into it, we really see two important things. We are able to separate two important dimensions of these industrial revolutions. Every human being has two important strength or faculty, which is called the physical strength and the mental strength. If you look at this industrial revolution that has happened over 200 years from 1800 to 2000, you will see Industrial Revolution 1 and 2 extraordinarily increase the physical capability of man. You can see huge cranes and huge cranes lifting tons and tons of weights of ship materials, and the fastest train and aerospace, you name any field, the physical strength of the human being has been increased. Simultaneously, did not stop there. In the year 1970s, the first microprocessor has come from the Intel lab. 1970s, 74, 4-bit microprocessor, 8-bit microprocessor. Then started another important revolution called IT revolution, which enhanced the mental capability of human being. So the extension of physical and mental capability of human beings also was part of this technological revolution. So these technological revolutions, be it industrial revolution 1, 2, 3, or 4, has really, in fact, indirectly enhanced both the physical capability and mental capability of human beings. Now, coming to the term transformations, as I said, dear friends who are all listening to this online webinar seminar on transforming electronics and communication engineering, I really took this into three different periods. Transformation that has happened in the 19th century, transformation that has happened in the 20th century, and the transformation that has happened in the 21st century, which is futuristic in nature. But unless we understand the past, unless we get inspiration and motivation from the past, and I think the future will be futile and void. Therefore, I wanted to tell you that there were extraordinary people who lived much before us, who gave almost everything in their life to the betterment of human society. Today, we are all here with all this facility because of those men who never slept and did a lot of things for us. So let us go through this transformation that has really happened in the 19th century technology. Linking electricity to magnetism, you have the Christian Oersted. And following him, you had Michael Faraday. These are all extraordinary transformations, my dear friends. Let me tell you, without this magnetism and electricity and the contributions of Oersted and Michael Faraday, I'm sure we would be jobless today. I would not have been a professor of electronics, because without these people, the field would not have grown, let me assure you. Therefore, let us all have highest regard to these people, wonderful men of extraordinary knowledge, extraordinary innovative thinking, extraordinary perseverance, persistence. And without Michael Faraday, I cannot imagine the field of electronics. And you have Michael Faraday and Joseph Henry brought out the solenoidal, which helped to lift huge mass of weights. And you can see Faraday conducted himself these excitations. And in fact, Faraday used to be a maniac, used to carry a small battery and then a magnet, a few wires and meters, and he used to connect them in a different fashion and wanted to see whether when I have a magnet, whether the current flows in the meter. 10 years, believe me, he did like this, and he never got anything. And also, when he invented the magnetic induction properties, he did notice that there are some waves which are propagating, and he never, because he did not try, he only visualized that, yes, during the when magnetism is converted to electricity and electricity is converted to magnetism, there are certain waves which travel. He believed in those waves, but he could not see it, and he himself did not test it, so he never dared to speak about it. Therefore, he wrote a letter in the year 1938 stating that I believe like this, but I'm not sure, I'm afraid because I'm not verified. Why don't you open this letter after exactly 100 years, that is 1838. So 1938, this letter was opened by British Royal Society. And to their surprise, whatever Maxwell has predicted, whatever Hertz has proved, whatever Marconi has practically proved, shown exactly this great man Faraday has said in his letter. I think this is the greatest gust of the century in terms of technological innovations. And here you have the great man, Maxwell. Maxwell and Michael Faraday did wonderful things to electronics, transformed electronics like anything else. It finds a breakthrough technology. It's a disruptive technology, in fact. So Maxwell predicted the electromagnetic theory. He just combined both electricity and magnetism. Hertz has proved it through this experiments there in the year 1885 and 1888. Ampere is again a great man. In fact, His wonderful contributions are seven reports, like seven posts along the borderline between electrostatics and electrodynamics. Then you have the great Thomas Alva Edison, and I did not tell about him, one of the greatest human being to descend on this world. He gave phonograph, light bulb, great robbery, movie. And he had almost 1,093 patents. And his last patent was at the age of 83, and he died in the age of 84. You can see how great a person he was. But what when you see the autobiographies of all these men, they were all bookbinders. They were ordinary people. In fact, Henry was a classed school teacher. And they had no formal education. And they were they have created technology which is disruptive. Alexander Graham Bell was a teacher. And he came out with a wonderful telephony. Then you have Morse code, Galileo. In fact, in 1899, he flashed the first wireless signal. And this was the first successful transatlantic radiograph message in 1902. It is again a great, this was the first wireless communication that has happened on Earth. So how can I leave this? How can I talk about electronics transformations without Galileo Marconi, a great person from Italy? Then you have the Fleming diode, modulation, amplification. One of the greatest invention of this world is the triode, or in the transistor form, in the semiconductor form, it is the transistor, Lee D. Forrest. And now let me tell you, dear friends, in spite of being one of the greatest scientists of that time, sometimes their words spoke the stupidity of the nature. Lord Kelvin, no doubt, is a great mathematician. He said, radio has no future. How to believe this? Today, there is radio waves, and there is no life without these radio waves. And believe me, Lord Kelvin, in the year 1897, has said, radio has no future. U.S. Commissioner of Patents in 1899 has said that everything whatever to be invented has already been invented. Therefore, there is nothing more to invent. I think he can close his patents office. This was his belief because he thought whatever is happening in his time, transformation that has happened in electronics and communication in his time, be it every field, he believed that nothing can happen beyond this. He thought that this is the end of the world. So everything that can be invented has been invented today, and no more tomorrow. How foolish he is. There is no reason for any individual to have a computer in their home. This is the statement of one of the greatest men. And I have taken you through this 19th century, important personalities, areas. Now let me take you through 20th century technology. This electronics can again divided into three important areas: electronics in communication, computation, and instrumentation. So the role of electronics, the significance of electronics, the manifestation of electronics can be thought as a communication and computation and instrumentation. Communication is transmission of information one place to place B, be it through wired or wireless channel. Computation is nothing but computing machines. It starts with the microprocessors, ends with the microcontrollers and huge computers, and instrumentation. Therefore, electronics, evolution of electronics and transformations in electronics, either it is in the 19th century or 20th century, 21st century or the future, cannot leave out the three big, huge dimensions of electronics, namely communication, computation, and instrumentation. Communication needs a source, a channel, and a receiver. Computation are nothing but computing machines, which are nothing but huge microprocessors, both hardware and the software, embedding of hardware and software. And instrumentation is nothing but the front end is fully sensors. So this is line communication. You have seen so many lines. You have twisted pair wire. Then you have the coaxial cable, optical fiber, waveguides, wireless communication happening through towers. And with the moment J.J. Thomson found out the electron, the role of electron, advent of electron, the physical means of communication has disappeared. There was a great transformation, in fact. There was a wonderful transformation from physical means of communication to electronic means of communication. So that's what I'm going through now. The transformation has happened from smoke signals, beating of drums, passenger pigeon, messengers, and then came the electronic age, pre-electronics, and then you can see in the 1920s, This was the telegraphy and telephony. The great pathfinders were Scott and Armstrong, the first loudspeaker. interaction of the components. Electronic circuits was fundamental. And then you have classical circuits here, the first radio, the first primitive galvanometer in the year 1890. I think it's a great journey. I enjoyed every bit of it. When I started preparing throughout night, day and night, I really enjoyed the journey of these transformations. Kudos to all those great men who did this oscilloscope. And then the first movie, the launching of the first talkies in the year 1928. I think blessed are those people who lived in those time. The microphone, men behind the circuits, Lee Forest, evolution of the magnetic recording. Today we have storage devices beyond our imagination. Was started in the initial in the 1965, and today you can see absolutely there is nothing to bridge them. Such is the human endeavor, such is the human excellence. The creativity of human is so much that transformation is unbelievable. Then microfrequency, microwave applications, evolution of electronics. Then you have radio communication, radio navigation, radar and navigational aids, the black and white television, how it is being projected. And then the electronic color television presented by RCA in the year 1947, exactly the year that we got independence, the first color television came into existence. Then the electromagnetic waves, so beautiful are them, the electromagnetic spectrum, the visible spectrum, and the non-ionizing radiation, ionizing radiation, and the sizes, which are too small to too big, as big as big, huge buildings, and the applications in various areas of human life, right from X-rays, gamma, CT scan, and whatnot. So these, and communication. So in every field, the electromagnetic waves have been, but highest regard I have for these waves, because most of them are unseen. I think as a human, I really feel that the metals, the antennas are able to see, but I am unable to see. The antennas are able to sense. The antennas are able to convert electromagnetic into electrical waves and show me a picture, show me a television, show me a, and make me listen to a song and make me see a movie. In spite of all the information available in space at each and every point, I'm unable to download. I need an antenna. Antenna is a better eye than the human eye that God has given to me. Then the radio. There's a transformation in the radio. Thomas Alva Edison invents wall, and Heinrich Rich transmits the radio wave, and Marconi proves that. And Alexander Popov is a very important Russian. In fact, he's behind the wireless communication. He's a man of communication. 1901, 1904, Ambrose Fleming creates first diode. Forrest creates first amplifier. In fact, this is one of the greatest invention in electronics. And without this today, there'll be no electronics, because whenever we touch lives of the people, I feel I'm touching that transistor. Without this three-legged transistor, there is no world. In every device you touch, in every device, let it be a our mobile phone, or a television, or a LCD, whatever electronic gadget you dream of, you think of, and you place it before you, when you touch the electronic device, you must understand you are touching a transistor. Without this transistor, absolutely no device can exist. And therefore, all the applications in the world, in every walks of life, needs a transistor. Therefore, when I say to my students, or to everybody on earth, that when I touch, the electronics touches the lives of the people, I unashamedly tell you that I am touching this wonderful, tiny device called transistor. Extraordinary device. And this enabling technology, you have the walls era, and then the transistor era, and then the IC era. Integrated circuits had a very great play, because it is integrated circuits which brought in the miniaturization. And you have the electronic devices, right from diode, transistors, BJTs, FETs, MOSFETs, LEDs, LCDs, and then a lot of other devices. That's a huge history. CMOS, silicon technology, solid state devices, is a first kind of electronic circuits. And in 1970s and 71, you can see the first generation of large scale integration circuits. You have the DRAM and the 4004 microprocessor in the year 1972. And then the downsizing has come, miniaturization has come, Moore's law has come, so VLSI has come. And here is the history you can kindly go through, because every history is very, very important, because without appreciating, without learning history, we will not get any motivation. Unless we appreciate our forefathers, we respect our father, I think there will be no respect for us. Therefore, it is onus on us. It demands that we have to understand the earlier history, earlier transformations, which will give us a lot of inspiration. And you can see down the line, right from 1904, 20th century, almost, you go through 1940, 1955, history continues. I see, revolution. This is the 1971 micro, this is where exactly, I think the first time in the world, in fact, in the next few slides, you may get it. The first time in the world to almost, there was a period, maybe in the 18th century and 19th century, 20th century, the hardware was separate and the software was separate. They never merged together. It is the first time in the year 1972 and 74 and 80s, with the advent of microprocessors and digital signal processors, there came a fusion between the hardware and the software. You got the embedded software. So that was a wonderful and greatest transformation that has happened to electronics and communication engineering. So 1971 is the beginning of an extraordinary transformation in electronics and communication. So 82, 86, microprocessor, then Pentium microprocessor. And people, when they saw Lee D. Forrest, who invented the triode, it was just simple. There were two diodes, diode and cathode and anode. You just put your third one, but that's what people say, that working of genius seems very simple, but putting the third and transforming an electronics field is the greatness of that great gentleman. You have vacuum tube era. Era in the history of electronics can be vacuum tube era, transistor era, and integrated era. The transistor, development of integrated circuits. In again, semiconductors, you have development decade, processing decade, production decade, automation decade, and production era. And this is exactly what I was trying to tell you, my dear friends, that when you go back to history from 2700 BC to till today, 1970, because I told you that 1970 is the striking field in the field of electronics. A great transformation has really happened, because there are two important fields, which is nothing but hardware and software. On one side, the hardware like Abacus in the 2700 BC, then the tubes. And you can see that astonishingly, nothing has happened between 2700 BC to 1940. That's what I told earlier also, amber rod. So no reason, but somehow 1940 caught up. And from 1940, there was no looking back. And every decade, there was a great transformation. So right from 2700 BC, the hardware, from Abacus, we moved on to 1940s, 1950s, 1960s, and 65s. And similarly, from 1500, 1930s, and 1965, the software algorithm too traveled along. But there was no fusion. Exactly in the year 1970 and 1980s, microprocessor and digital signal processor, the hardware and software married, and we got into plastic feedback from excellent. Yes, this is line communication, optical communication, optical network, wireless communication, and radios and electromagnetic waveforms. And these are all some of the changes that you have seen. Antennas, the transmission. Yeah, you can see orthogonal. The electric field and magnetic field traveling orthogonally. And you have satellites, GEO, MEO, LEO, and then the GPS is the greatest invention of this century. Automatic vehicle location, signals and system transmission lines and networks, wireless technologies, and reason I need not tell you. So these are all wonderful transformation that has happened. I can quickly go through this. Anyhow, this will be available as a recorded mode. And analog and digital communication, PCB layout, television systems, these are all transformation, codec, integrated circuits, electronic circuits and communication. And these are the people who are responsible for inventing GPS, global positioning system. They are from John Hopkinson's University, USA. And these are the three. And they have gave us the GPS, then microelectronics. And now, as I told you, that the electronics is a combination of communication, computation, and instrumentation. Now I'm going through this communication. That is, we have seen the transformations in communication. Now let us go through computation. These are the computing machines, as I told you, microprocessors, Intel processors, 8085, 8086, 8186, 386, 486, 586, and so on and so forth. So this is what you are seeing now. you can see computer hardware and interfacing, motherboard, transformations in hard disk, transformations in Intel processors, transformations in memory, memory sound card, monitors, storage devices, modem, keyboard, printers, speakers, cameras, tablet, and see, these are all hardware transformations. Again, you have great transformations in software, computational languages, machine language, assembly language, language of microprocessors, microcontrollers, DSPs, and then procedure-oriented languages like C, C++, Java, Visual Basic. So, which means transformation not only happened in hardware, but also has happened in software, in OS, and in algorithms. Operating systems have transformed. Computer generations have transformed to 4 generations. Microprocessor, there was transformation. VLSI circuit design. You can see this is the greatest transformation right from 1974, 4004, 8080, and then the latest Pentium processor. Here is a Motorola series, great transformation in processors. Then you have Zilog series. Then Jack S. Kilby, the man of the father of integrated circuits, microprocessors. Evolution of microprocessors in terms of data bus, address bus, speed, and the year is given here. Interfacing devices, yeah, you have 8085, 8080, 8255, 8279, 8254, 8251, they're all interfacing devices. You have a series of processors on the left, 8085, 8086, and they're all central processing units. On the other hand, you have the real world printer, serial communication, FDD, HDD, mouse, etc. Between these two worlds, you have to have interfacing devices like 8255, 8279. Therefore, transformations have also happened, you can see from the top to bottom. Processors have evolved, have transformed in electronics and communication engineering. The interfacing devices have evolved, and then the real facility has evolved. Different types of printers have come. Serial communication has changed. Floppy disk has changed. The way monitors today are totally changed. So computer communication, and finally the instrumentation, then sensors, you have extraordinary sensor, cathode ray, digital multimeter, and evolution of sensors from MEMS, micro electromechanical sensors, to nano sensors today, electronic devices, many sensors are on play, and you have green electronics, avionics, robotics, and then and another important field is medical electronics. And in medical electronics, let me go through again, there is a transformation. Medical electronics without electronics is nothing. It is a multidisciplinary field with major contribution from electronics and communication engineering. So this medical electronics, biomedical engineering, is a beneficiary of electronics and communication engineering. And the great achievements in this field of biomedical field is in the year 1950s and so is artificial kidney, x-rays, electrocardiogram, cardiac pacemaker, cardiopulmonary bypass, then antibiotic production technology, defibrillator. And these are the things in 1950s and earlier, we saw these are the great achievements of biomedical field with the help of electronics. In 1960s, you have heart valve replacement, intraocular lens, ultrasound, vascular grafts, blood analysis and processing. These are the achievements of 1960s. These are the transformations in the field of medical electronics. So I consider medical electronics as an offshoot of electronics and communication engineering, and these ultrasound, vascular grafts, blood analysis, processing, is everything, there is an electronic component in that. So 1970s saw computer-assisted tomography, CT, artificial hip and knee replacement, balloon catheter, endoscopy, biological plant, and these are the achievements of 1970s, and 1980s MRI, laser surgery, vascular stent, recombinant therapeutics, these are 1980s, and 1990s till today, you have genome sequencing, PET scan, image-guided surgery, and whatnot. So you have a summary of timeline. So extraordinary transformation that has happened in the one of the offshoots of electronics and communication engineering, namely the medical electronics. And finally, almost we are coming to an end. Maybe in another 10 minutes, I'll be closing my web series on transformations in electronics communication engineering. Dear friends, I have defined education. I have given you a glimpse of what are the basics of education, what really is the education. Then I have taken you transformation through 19th century, 20th century, and the great personalities and great modalities through which all these were achieved, and great appreciation to all of them. And finally, today, we are sitting on a huge Himalaya, in fact. There's a lot to achieve and a lot of things to come. So you can see that emerging technologies in electronics and impacting futures are digital set technology. E-textiles, molecular electronics, which uses molecules as primary building block for nano electronic industry. Lot of research is going on in this angle. One of our respected speaker has rightly pointed out that I have to touch upon the future requirements and the future research topic. Yeah, these are all future research topics. Some of them are in the implementation stage, and right now, these are all some of the hot topics that my dear friends can really take it up. Electronic nose identifies certain components of an odor and analyzes chemical makeup. It's a very, very fertile ground to work with, because I used to say that, a television. Right now, I may be sitting in front of television and watching. In fact, my hobby is cooking. So I like how things are being prepared. So I see a man who will be explaining what are the components of ingredients of making a particular, a chutney or sambar. But the only thing is, I'm able to listen to him. I'm able to see him how he does, but I'm unable to smell it. So if I have a television in which I can see, I can hear, also I can smell the dish, I think nothing like that. So what prevents electronics and communication engineering to transform this? Electronic nose, and electronic tongue, and electronic touch looks little far away. Today we have mastered television and telephony. That is, we have mastered the two organs, eye and mouth and ear. So these three are really mastered. We have electronic devices which can do anything on these three important things. But unfortunately, we have to extend the nose, the functions of the nose, the functions of the tongue, and the functions of the touch, the skin. I think it is right here. I would like to request all my young friends who are listening to this that, yeah, sit down, come out with an extraordinary e-nose, come out with an extraordinary e-tongue, come out with an extraordinary e-touch. I think this is the future technology. Biometrics. Then here you have a stretchable, flexible, self-healing materials. Yeah, just like you can see a lizard, when its tail is cut off, it can grow. But when our finger is cut off, it will not grow. So do we have a technology tomorrow, from now, another 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, can you have self-healing materials that can mimic the features of an animal or a human skin? That is called electronic skin. An electronic tongue, on the other hand, measures and compares taste, multiple sensors. So I think it's quite interesting. I leave it to you. Now you can see many consumer electronic products. Manufacturers are showing interest, flexible displays. So I think that the tomorrow technology really lives in display devices. There's a revolution taking place in display devices. AI, artificial intelligence, is paving way for the future of electronics industry. I mean, in the manufacturing industry, new generation of connected cars, the satellite is able to control all the cars, the autonomous vehicle, self-driving. Everything is controlled by probably a satellite. And there is a contention. A good competition is going between the satellite communication people and the 5G people. 5G people believe that they can still control without the help of satellite. And it's an interesting tangle that we have to go through. Here we have the drones. Tomorrow it will be full of drones. Drones for bomb detection, air striking, surveillance, filming, journalism, shipping, delivery, disaster management, security, rescue operations, healthcare, archaeological survey, geographical mapping, agriculture, wildlife monitoring, weather forecasting, and whatnot. I think drones will have multiple applications and multiple design technologies. And I think this is a very fertile area for us to work. And as India, we need the great minds to work on this. We have to have self-atmanirbhar. We have to have the resilience. Today, the time has come. India cannot look back. We have to come out with our own design. And today, government is also favorable for establishing electronic system design and electronic fabs and electronic manufacturing facilities. I think it is right time that all the stakeholders in electronics and communication has to sit and take up this challenge and prove ourselves. So IoT is everything, be it transport, utilities, smart cities, environment, industries, surveillance, etc. IoT is the future. By 2020, 50 billion devices will be connected by IoT. 3D printing, again, is coming very fast, and it's a faster time to market, great freedom of design and customization, and it can be delivered for electronic system design. And you can see that 3D printing is one which makes use of plastic, metal, nylon, as well as many other material. They create funny figurines, but what is more important is It does not stop there. What is more important, it can even create prototypes, weapons and aircraft parts, various devices and even human organs. So you can see 3D printing will really help us in designing electronic devices, electronic circuits. Yes, you can go to your shop, allow you to print things at home. You can print in future whatever you are going and trying to go and buy whatever things in your shop, you can do it in your home itself. So 3D printing will allow you to print things at home. Normally you would traditionally buy in store or online, have them printed nearby location. It is possible. And also the great pizzas, the candy, cake, you can print them and eat. So 3D printing has come to that stage. So 3D printing can be used even in our domestic homes. New machines can be actually print food like candy, cake and pizza from fresh ingredients. It's all fun, looks like fun, but it's a great balanced diet and a great thinking behind it. And also 3D printing can be used for teaching purposes, because 3D printers will help students create models, projects, conceptual diagrams to better learn and study. Educators, schools and museums can use low cost but accurate replica of art of artificers. And I think sky is the limit for applications. And then you can go for cars are already being made with 3D printed parts. You can make your own car using the 3D printers. Also, you can build your home. See, as simple as that. You can build your wonderful home, eco-friendly home using these 3D printers. And you can use materials, use them for recycling. Therefore, 3D printers can be used for reducing the environmental pollution. And 3D printing, my dear friends, can save lives, because you can print dental implants, affordable prosthetics, pharmaceutics, and the cash, whatnot. So 3D printing is very useful in healthcare. Also in customization, the biggest impact of 3D printing will be customization. You have the right materials and right specifications, you can really do anything under the sky, from clothes to jewelry, to human organs, to smartphones and computers. 50,000 people have been benefited because of the 3D printing in healthcare. And this new technology can also speed up and process innovation and create many jobs opportunities. Possibilities, dear friends, are endless. Teaching and learning is very important. Augmented voltage reality in education, healthcare, in recruitment, in tourism, yes, in immersive video conference, because now work from home has become a norm. So naturally, immersive future, AR and VR are very important. Even my son uses virtual technology. He's learning, he's studying in Indian Institute of Management. He uses all augmented voltage technology. It's very interesting. Then you have the banking sector and big data, likely to indispensable assets again, and robotics and manufacturing, healthcare. And you have the automation, transportation, security, defense, see, cooking, medicine, education, home maintenance by robots. The robots are engaged for dangerous jobs, crime fighting, and also it's your servant, also your friend. Smart surfaces and electronic billboards and electronic signs as I told you, the display devices are going to rule us tomorrow. The next century belongs to the display devices, wearables, both for monitoring and fitness, chronic disease prevention for asthma people, ultimate TV. Chronic diseases and prevention of wearables, critical infrastructure. This is very, very important, because today every country looks after the critical infrastructure, and this should not come down at any cost. Therefore, cyber crimes, cyber security is very important. In that context, securing critical structure is utmost important for any country. 5G is the backbone of that. 5G will usher the fourth industrial revolution. And dear friends, with all these things, we have to look for only green electronics. We should not spoil the subtle balance that the earth gives us. We should not destroy it. We have to have green cars, consumer electronics, personalized medicine, e-electrical vehicles, aerospace technologies, and whatnot. If this is not enough, I think all of us, see, what I have given is a minuscule of knowledge that is available in the whole world. The knowledge is infinity. In fact, I am sure I might not have justified the transformation that has happened in electronics and communication engineering, because there is infinite number of electronics and transformation has happened in electronics and communication engineering. I have just touched upon a little bit of it here and there, but I am happy that given this opportunity, I hope I have justified my lecture on web series on transformations and electronics communication engineering. But my dear friends, this is only a beginning. I have given you only the tip of an iceberg. There are huge knowledge laying outside. There are excellent people. You please go through a lot of other webinars and go through the internet, go through textbooks. I think you are going to win. So go to library. And yes, every lecture I want to leave you like this, because after leaving you like this, I think I will leave you like this. All the crocodiles are waiting to catch you. The idea is that each crocodile here is a challenge. So don't think life is just a very rosy and beautiful place to live. Life is full of struggles. Life is full of challenges. So I wish that after my lecture, all of you should be in this situation. I'm going to throw you into this lake full of challenges. Please come out successfully. Excitement is just beginning. Technology will not be our limitation. We are limited by our own imagination, my dear friends. Please don't say that I don't have this and that and this. You have everything. You are limited by your own imagination. Make it. Yes, queries, questions, and India is a great country. You have great Himalayas, beautiful Kashmir. Then you have Ganges Lifeline, desert, Thar Desert, beautiful Kerala, and wonderful temples. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Are there any queries? Sir, shall we stop presenting the screen?
Yeah.
It's not stopped, sir. Sir, your screen is presenting. Hello? Yeah.
Oh, no. Screen enga irukku? Screen. Screen, ma.
You just have to do stop sharing, sir.
Stop sharing. Stop sharing for it. Yeah, okay. Madam?
Yes, sir. I think...
Am I visible?
Yeah, you are visible, sir. You are visible. Just a moment. Yeah. So, are there any questions? Can we ask the participants?
Why not, madam? You are most welcome.
Yeah, actually, sir, in chat box, appreciations are there. Lot many appreciations.
Thank you, madam.
In the chat box, lots. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, very much, madam.
Yes, sir. Loud and clear. In chat box, no questions are there. Only appreciations are there. Lots of appreciations are there.
Most welcome. So, anyhow.
We have two.
I thank
professors.
All the participants for having.
Yes, sir. We have two eminent professors also, so we take their views also. So,
yeah, please, madam.
Yeah. Research shows that the climate of an organization influences an individual's contribution far more than the individual himself. And you proved it, sir. Thank you, Professor Mutten, sir, for your insightful presentation on the webinar topic. You are truly a motivational benchmark to the researchers and academicians, sir, of our country. Thank you very much for your excellent elaborative delivery on transformations and electronics.
In fact, I should thank you and Dr. Raghavan.
Yes, sir. Communication engineering with beautiful slides you have presented, sir.
Yeah.
It was very nice to
I
see
love those slides.
Colorful slides. Yeah. And you have motivated the audience. Thank you so much, sir, for sparing your valuable time also with us. it is a great honor of our institute to have a very dynamic technocrat, a seasoned scholar and navigator of this flagship of knowledge and eminent personality, Professor V. Mahadevan, scientist ISRO and currently professor at Electronics and Communication Engineering, PES University, Bangalore, as a guest of honor today in this webinar. We are indeed privileged to have an eminent scientist, Professor V. Mahadevan, with us. I request you, sir, to bless us with your words. Yeah, Professor Mahadevan, I request you to please bless us with your words. Are you there, sir? Yeah, Mahadevan, sir, are you there? Mahadevan, sir, please unmute yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, please.
I am very much there. See, I was not able to unmute. So yeah, just now I could do it. Okay.
Yes,
It was an really a classic presentation by Professor Muthan.
And thank you, sir.
I don't know whether he has left any area in this field of electronics which anybody could think of. So right from the basics of just electricity and magnetism, which our forefathers, I mean, I should say real forefathers of Faraday, Ampere, Maxwell, etc., who really laid the foundation, to this day, when you come to the processor-based system, and that too, the microprocessors and its evolution. And every area, no, every area, every slide he presents, it presents the complete growth or the transformation in that particular one. If he gives a slide on microprocessor, yes, what is the variations? What are the revolutions which has taken place in that? If he has gone to, finally went up to 3D, I think people may not know that much applications are there. He has brought in so many applications for 3D. Apart from that, there are every area, says, starting from transistor. In fact, a few years back, if you remember, there was a special issue on 50 years of transistors edited by Proceeding Science. So that 50 years itself was few years back. So that itself was so inspiring to learn about one single device of a transistor. Now you can imagine the whole gamut of electronics which has really gone. And one of the very major areas where it has really got into the social media as well as the humanitarian is the medical side. The medical electronics have really become extremely useful, and you cannot think of anything today without the presence of electronics in medicine. So every aspect in that is so great in that. And you being an expert in that area clearly brought out various gadgets and other things. Many of those gadgets we would have never heard also, unless we have been in contact with the hospital for anything or other. But most of these, they have really come up to a very great extent. Apart from that, the great communication which has really happened, one of our greatest no doubt Marconi was the first to demonstrate, but we had Jagadish Chandra Bose, who never knew anything about, but at 60 gigahertz, that is at millimeter waves, he demonstrated, and it's very recently that IEEE has recognized and given him the due regard of what work he has done. All this is a very great honor for India for having done such a good work at that early stage where no components or this were really available. Everything is through his imagination. So that was a very great thing. In fact, the amount of knowledge which you have transmitted through this particular seminar, if any student can really get all of them together, he can make a PhD thesis out of it. In fact, as you say, whatever is left out, go to the library, get it, and then he can make a full-fledged PhD thesis out of it. That is the amount of knowledge and the depth which you have gone through. And I can imagine the amount of time you would have really spent to give such a type of webinar to students of this present day. It's not easy to give lecture to a student of present day because they are so much knowledgeable, because everything is available in the net. Is so knowledgeable are these days. So it has been very great, this thing. And but two major areas, of course, of electronics is always space, that is satellite communication and other space, and other one is defense. Space and defense. And apart from that, nowadays, of course, the medical electronics is the third great one. So the telemedicine, as you were just trying to point out, has become so very useful, specifically yes, during this pandemic time.
Hello?
So it was really great. Okay, this pandemic time, people are not able to go to hospitals. They are all taking only this thing, consulting using the wireless media. So it's such a great this thing. And I thank the organizers for having chosen such a perfect person for giving a lecture of this caliber. Thank you and wish you all the best. I am sure the students should take full advantage of whatever he has told. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. I wholeheartedly thank you, sir, for your inspiring and encouraging words. We wish to express our gratitude to you, sir, for being with us on this event today. Your presence was motivation to all of us. Thank you for adding the values to this webinar with your valuable presence and encouraging words. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
It gives me immense pleasure to invite the very popular, the voice of the microwave community. I feel so energized to invite such a legend of microwave engineering, Professor S. Raghavan, sir, our guest of honor today, to bless us with your address, sir. Over to you, sir. Raghavan, sir, over to you, sir.
I think we are not able to unmute. That was the problem even with me.
Yeah, okay.
So you have to make sure that they are able to unmute.
Okay. Yeah. Actually, sir is calling me on my WhatsApp call, but somehow I am unable to receive his call also. Raghavan, sir, can you, I have unmuted you. Can you please... Are you there, sir? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, please, sir. Yeah, Raghavan, sir, are you there, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah, am I audible, sir? Raghavan, sir, are you there? Are you connecting it or you? Yeah, actually he's calling me on WhatsApp call, but I am unable to pick up the call. Somehow my settings are not allowing me to pick up the call. Meantime, by the time he resolves his issues, Sir is also there, and our chief guest is also there throughout the session. They both are attending. And in spite, Director Sir is belonging to chemical technology throughout the session of Muttan, sir. You kept engaged all of us. So let me request Honorable Director Sir to please, sir, share your views, sir. And
thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much. Really, I am really delighted to listen to the talk of Professor Muttan. Really, it was quite informative, and in my life, really, I have come across the second person in my life with such observation in saying that. One is Professor Premrath. He's a professor at IIT Delhi, and later on he became Vice Chancellor of Uttar Pradesh Technical University. I never found any speaker of his stature, and today I got another one. really, I am really thankful to you, sir. And I am of the strong opinion that education is the only media which can transform the society in a number of the ways. If by any methodology we are able to recruit persons like your stature in the academics, really, we can transform the society. We can transform our country also. So there is a great scope. But anyhow, the processes are like that the persons who love academics are very few, very rare. Really, I bow my head to you. I salute you, sir.
and I'm thankful to the
Pardon? Actually, Raghavan sir is saying that he is unable to connect. Some issues are there. Please, sir.
And this is the magic of Professor Mutton, that DRM sir has continuously been associated with this webinar.
With your permission, I would also like to say
Yes, sir. Sure.
Professor Mutton, it was an excellent session. In fact, it started really well, continued, and ended really well. With what you initially told about what is education, the way you told, that was totally something to listen to. Then invention, innovation, discovery, how you brought out in this lecture. And then how you correlated electronics with the teamwork. Then the human senses, that how more we need to work. People don't think about it much, but the taste and the nose, the smell, these are the future things to come out. And to top it all, in the end, the way these senses are to be developed, and how artificial intelligence is to be developed, how drones are to be used in future, IoT, 3D printing, green environment. It was an excellent lecture. In fact, in the midway, I was thinking, my daughter, who has joined recently engineering, and she has chosen electronics and computers also. So I was thinking that she should have also joined this session. Anyway, it was an excellent session, and I was taking such a session after a long time. What I was worried about listening for such a long time, I should not get dozed off, but it was an excellent session.
Thank
and
you. Thank you, sir.
You kept us continuously such a way that totally focused, and excellent lecture.
Most welcome, sir. Thank you.
And I would like Director Mr. Tyagi, I would like to leave the webinar in midway. I have some other engagement at 17:30 hours.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Yeah. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, Director sir, I think Raghavan sir is having some problem joining to this particular session.
Over to DK.
Yeah, he's there, sir. DK sir is there. DK sir is there. So, actually, Dr. Maheshwari, I was not knowing that sir, he has also joined the session. But I could see in the list, Dr. Maheshwari, Professor Raghavan has stated something in chat box. So are you there? Would you like to share something?
Professor Raghavan is not able to unmute. He has messaged.
Please
unmute him.
Oh, I have unmuted him. I have unmuted. Just a moment. I couldn't see him.
Yeah, ma'am. This is yes. Dr. Maheshwari.
Yeah, yeah.
Now only I am able to unmute, ma'am.
Yes. Please, madam.
I really thank Dr. Raghavan sir to give this link to join
this webinar.
Actually, as everybody told, the session was excellent. Dr. Mutton sir, I already knew about him because he was a DC member for one of my friends' research during her research. So I know Dr. Mutton sir very well. Actually, the session, as everybody told, it was excellent. He gave a lot of research topic also. Actually, now I was talking with my son about that artificial intelligence-based electronic tongue. Okay, so all the topics are very, very useful and research oriented also. So I thank Dr. Muthan sir for having given this excellent talk. And I also thank Dr. Raghavan sir for making me to join in this webinar. And all your organization was very well, ma'am. It was excellent. You have organized the program excellently. It was very nice, ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Maheshwari.
Raghavan sir has joined.
Yes, sir. Please, sir. With your permission, one minute, sir.
It gives me immense pleasure to invite the very popular, the voice of the microwave community. I feel so energized to invite such a legend of microwave engineering, Professor S. Raghavan, our guest of honor today, to bless us with your address. Over to you, sir.
Maybe highly valuable participants. I'm sure that every one of you got transformed. I just want to tell some few things. The chief guest, DRM, wanted to leave in the middle, but he did not leave. The great director also did not leave. 135 participants were glued to their seat because of the transformation. We don't need big saint to get transformation. Here is a person who can transform us technically. And there are very few things. I cannot tell all the 135 persons' feedback. Very few feedback, including Dr. Muthan's friend, Dr. SRK of NIT Tiruchi. Hats off, highly informative, minus infinity, zero to plus infinity. Many, many more things. These are the few samples of the feedback. Then, if only the DRM has not told, 30 years before when I joined railways, we would have assumed that a very young person only joined as a chief guest. And if at all, he has done a lot of contribution to railways, it is only because of ECE. Correctly, he told one sentence, ECE is the connecting branch. In that connection, I want to say, in this podium, there's a person, multidisciplinarian, who encourages micro electromechanicalism, everything. He just wants all the branch people to join, and he is no other than a person whose bio data runs into pages, and he is none other than Dr. V.K. Tyagi, director. Third thing I want to tell to the participants, we have got one very young HOD also. Behind him only all things are going on. Everyone would have seen one professional MOC. Please don't think she has come from any TV. Don't think she has come from a radio. She is simply a dean of a BIET, and she's one of the very, very few who is good in both biomedical and microengineering. Very recently, in front of the director, she was given a title. I'm sure every one of you will agree. She has been given a title of Jhansi Rani. And the last one I want to tell, some days before, HOD is admiring. D.K. Srivastava is admiring when I say Jhansi Rani. Okay, this is my last sentence. Some 10 years before, I heard one lecture. The title of the lecture was Vision 2021. Not Vision 2020. Vision 2020 was given by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Vision 2021 was given by a person who talked same thing what he talked 10 years before in the last few slides. And he is no other than Dr. Muthan. And I want to say, Dr. SRK will be knowing Raghavan is an enemy to many people because he talks openly. So in the same way, I want to tell one thing. I keep telling Dr. Muthan is an ethical biomedical person. The reason why I told ethical is, at one time, with due apology, I'm telling, he threw a post equivalent to vice chancellor post, just for the ethics reason. And it is because of that only, he and his team has come out with the innovation for avoiding, preventing COVID-19. And another thing I want to tell to all the faculty members, including Raghavan, none of his presentation will be repetitive one. every presentation he puts effort and presents a new thing. That is a very, very rare among the teaching faculty. So I feel very happy that I have introduced everyone in the South knows who is Dr. Mutton, but I wanted to bring Dr. Mutton through Jhansi Rani and Dr. V.K. Tyagi to the other end of India. Soon, both of them will take him internationally also. That much work, every slide, really it is a fact, 135 persons did not move out because of his wonderful presentation. That's all I can say. I can say many more things next time, they won't call me. And we have got, in this audience, we have got the students who have got 99.9 percentile, direct from Ladakh to Kanyakumari, from Calcutta to Gujarat. All the students are creamy layers are with us. Most, instead of taking Dr. Mutton to Tiruchi, I have brought Tiruchi to Jhansi. Then we have got the second most highest ISRO person, Professor Mahadevan, who has played a very big role in Chandrayaan. He is also here. Many, many more persons. Really, it is a delighted talk. One more thing, what others do not do is, in addition to the technical feast, Dr. Mutton is one of the very, very few who readily gives the wonderful, colorful, technical PPT also. That is all, because he doesn't want PPT. Tomorrow's lecture will be another PPT. So many, many more things I would like to tell about him. And I really thank him. In the next minute, he agreed.
Thank you.
I did not even have the number. I asked 2-3 persons. Next second, subject knowing people will be like that only. So I wish the COVID-19 will be out. If he comes out with some more research papers, as usual, I request the multidisciplinarian Professor Dr. V.K. Tyagi to say one more feedback about the great Dr. Mutton.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. I'm honored.
Director, sir.
One or two sentences from the director.
Yes, sir. Director, sir. Unmute yourself, sir. Yeah.
Yes. Yes, madam. Yes, yes, sir.
One or two sentences from your side.
Really, I am really very much thrilled to have such a nice talk. And Professor Mutton, really, I think there is no any thing.
Yeah, I think bandwidth is low, sir. Bandwidth is low.
On which words are not coming out, basically. The depth of the knowledge, the presentation, and the connectivity, the ideas and the development, transformations taking place in the area of the electronics is strictly unparalleled. And what Professor Raghavan has also, his knowledge and his innovative ideas will percolate from the South also. We will also do lot many things in association with him and we'll keep in touch with him. And really, participants will definitely be benefited because he has opened a new vistas for the researchers also, that there are n number of the applications of electronics and communication engineering in the daily life, and which will be beneficial for the society as a whole. So really, really, I am very much thankful to you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Yeah, thank you, Director, sir. And thank you, Professor Raghavan, sir. I need to multiply thank you word 1,000 times to match it with your efforts. It is because of you only we got interacted with Professor Mutton. And lot many participants, the great researchers have joined this webinar because of you only. So thank you very much, sir, for being with us today with active involvement and guidance. I wholeheartedly thank you for your inspiring, encouraging, thought-provoking address. Thank you, sir. Now I request Professor D.K. Srivastava, Head Electronics and Communication Engineering, BIT Jhansi, to share his views also and to propose the vote of thanks also.
Thank you, madam. Am I audible, madam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please.
Okay. Respected Director, sir, Chief Guest of this event, Sri Sandeep Mathur, Honorable DRM Jhansi, Guest of Honor of this webinar, Professor Raghavan, NIT Trichy, and Professor V. Mahadevan, Senior Scientist, ISRO, Dr. Anil Kumar, State Project Administrator, SPIU, UP, Professor A.K. Nigam, TechCube Coordinator, my colleagues, faculty members, and all participants. I am very much thankful to our Honorable Director, Professor V.K. Tyagi, sir, for his kind support, guidance, and motivation. I am thankful to Chief Guest of this occasion, Sri Sandeep Mathur ji, DRM Jhansi, who spent his valuable time from his busy schedule to grace this occasion and bless us. I am thankful to Dr. Anil Kumar, State Project Administrator, SPIU, UP, for his support and helping us by organizing this event in joint coordination with SPIU, UP. I am heartily thankful to Professor S. Mutton, Anna University, Chennai, who delivered such a nice lecture and benefited us with his knowledge and experience. I am thankful to Professor Raghavan, NIT Trichy, and Professor V. Mahadevan, sir, for joining us. Sir, your presence has motivated us and raised the level of this webinar. I am thankful to Dr. Mahavir, Nodal Officer, SPIU, UP, for his support to organize this event in joint coordination with BIT Jhansi. I am thankful to Professor A.K. Nigam, TechCube Coordinator, for your support regarding financial approvals. I am thankful to coordinator of this webinar, Dr. Sehnaaz Ayub, who took a lot of pain to organize this webinar. I am thankful to participants who attended it and hope this has been fruitful to them. Lastly, I am thankful to all who directly or indirectly associated with this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, my humble thanks to Professor Raghavan, Tyagi, sir, Srivatsava, Shamnaz, madam, Sandeep Mathur, for everybody, all the
thank you, sir.
Dear colleagues. Thank you again.
Thank you.
We'll meet again.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you,
director, thank you, madam. Yeah. Aapne kiya hai ye sab.
Oh, no, sir. It's have spared your valuable time, and if Professor Raghavan...
No, I love to spend. Yeah. It's my duty, madam. I love to do all these things for the sake of our own students.
But lot many thanks to Raghavan, sir, because of him only you could accept our invitation.
He was an excellent person, madam. Raghavan is not... He speaks so... But extraordinary man. I had a wonderful time with him in Tiruchi. I cannot forget those wonderful moments. Sir, thank you, sir. Raghavan, sir.
We'll meet again.
We see you. We will see too. We will meet again. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Hotel, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Raghavan, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Mahadevan, sir.
Yeah, for all dear parties.
Director, sir, thank you.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you, D.K. Srivastava, sir.
Yeah.
I should thank you.
See you, sir. HOD.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice. Raghavan, sir. See you, sir. Bye.
Yes, sir. Dear all participants, the feedback link is shared in chat box. So if I request all of you to fill the feedback so that it will help us to improve in further sessions.
Good.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So, sir, shall we close the meeting, sir?
Yeah, please, madam.
Thank you, sir.